Verdinken.
2020, definitely second best.
Second best year of your life?
Second best, arguably the best year of my life.
Yeah. So what was better?
2019 was better.
So what? How come second best? Like, what was so good about this year?
Like, a lot of time to think for yourself.
You deferred the whole year, yeah?
I deferred from mid last year to mid this year. So like towards the end of last year, that's why last year was such an amazing year for me. Mm. Towards the end of last year, I had a lot of time to myself.
Ooh,
a lot of a lot of just alone time. Just very, very.
What? You're a stoic.
Wait. I don't understand that. That's not even English to me, but anyway.
No, nah, but you started the podcast last year. That's why.
Yeah.
So that's when you started having the most growth.
Me, you blokes, wallah. And then like that gave me a different outlook to things. And this year started, and COVID hit out of nowhere. I'm like, this is a bit weird.
Do you remember when you sent us that message? Like you're more self-aware, and you had that like couple days of reflection. You didn't use your phone for a couple days.
Yeah.
Even like WhatsApp, we're sending you WhatsApp messages. You didn't reply. When you sent that message, I'm like, nah, this guy's been, you know,
that's more
obviously
like
changing.
Month.
Yeah. However long it was, yeah, I remember that, and I was like, this is what you want to hear, like from your phones. Like you're sending messages that about what you want to change. And like hold me accountable.
We were generally worried about you.
No, that was
good. I wasn't worried.
No, actually was.
You reckon?
Yeah, 100%. We're like, where the hell's up shit? Like, he went proper, like...
He didn't use WhatsApp. He's like, no social media.
Yeah.
I didn't use Twitter. I use Twitter regularly.
Yeah, he actually properly went off Twitter. And that's weird. Yeah.
So what, like...
Like, it was the injury, because I couldn't move anywhere.
True.
I couldn't do anything at all. Then, COVID hit. Lockdown. I'm home alone. I can't... not home alone. Like, I can't move. I can't leave the house. And then... What was it called? I'm forced to stay in the house. If I wanted to leave, I can't leave. It's just a lot of, I'm here right now. What am I doing? Where's my life going?
So you could hit like more goals? What was it? Because I know like financially, like a lot of people, because you didn't spend as much. Normally you used to go petrol weekly, shopping, buying stuff.
Eating out.
I did a lot of online shopping. Yeah, eating out. But because of that, you could just financially hit like goals you wanted.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is good.
It's not even finance. I think I've said it before in different podcasts, but...
How many podcasts?
Different episodes of this podcast.
Yeah. He's cheating on us, yeah?
Goodness gracious. Yeah, I'm like just a lot of time just to think about every single action I'm doing every single day. Every single day I wake up, this particular time. Why am I waking up this time? Okay, I'm going out with the boys. I'm going to go do a podcast, okay? All right, what are we talking about today? That is one thing, okay? Is that a good thing for me? Is that a bad thing for me? Okay, am I spending time with family? There's so many questions.
So you're more self-aware.
Yeah, a lot more. This guy is always reflection.
Soul-searching.
Soul-searching.
He's had an existential crisis.
Yeah, something like that.
Young lad has lost the plot.
Yeah.
Found the plot again. Lost it again. Found it.
Yeah, 2020 is a memorable year.
But other than that, apart from just being self-aware and all that, just like... I don't think we've ever been in such a crisis. It's just a weird situation to be in at home for 6 months, 7 months, not doing anything.
Reel it back real quick, yeah? Why, what caused your first crisis of the year other than the coronavirus pandemic? Because I remember at the start of the pandemic, you're like, you're all right, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Normal up shit, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. And then there was something that caught, was it the foot injury?
Ankle injury. And then, but not even just that, I think something just clicked.
Yeah.
Do you know what it could be? Because I had the same kind of thing this year, or even surgery, because we both had injuries. Me and you were very we're talkative people. We like being social, and this year kind of taught us to enjoy our own free time, enjoy alone time.
Yeah.
So I know you and I chatted about it before. Like we kind of learned a new part of our identity.
Yeah.
And we kind of find comfort in being alone, kind of thing.
Yeah. That's what a lot of people could close.
Yeah, that as well. Like, I swear to God, it sounds very weird. I think that plus, all the situations that I was in, I'm forced to be alone. Okay, wow, I really like this now. Okay.
You started reading. That was what I was. That's the biggest change.
That's what I knew. And then you fell off.
And I was like, wait, compared to before, I was always posting stuff on social media, always using it constantly. Yeah, that was literally a woke up tweet type stuff, all day long. Yeah. And then now I'm like in the middle of COVID, I'm like, whoa, okay. I don't like it anymore. It's just, this is very like I'm not lying to you, because I had that little bit of a situation where what's going on? Like I was a bit scared if that's the word.
Scared of.
Scared of because well, okay, I'm here now. It's a different world. I'm alone. I don't want to tweet. I don't want to post stuff on social media. I don't want to be out there anymore.
But you're learning more. Like you're scared. Is it because you're learning more about yourself?
Yeah, because like, I haven't been here before.
I realize like sometimes like you know when you get bored, are you comfortable being alone with your thoughts? And like, why do I go on social media? Is it like as a escape mechanism or distraction?
Yeah.
Then it's like that's where this COVID kind of taught me. It's like sometimes being alone is like about friends. Do I have friends? Why is no one messaging me? Do I just spend time watching TV? Where do I distract myself? But then to kind of have like a avenue and learn like personal growth, it was a year to grow and like kind of find yourself.
Mm. Bro,
is that the same for you?
I'm gonna say something.
Don't say the opposite.
It might be controversial, but
yes, sir.
After the first lockdown, you remember the first lockdown?
Yeah. They started like June and July was opening. Like,
yeah. You know, let it go. And I actually made a dua that the lockdown happened again.
Oh,
well, like, okay, I genuinely, I remember going to my, like my, okay, hey, last night I actually made a dua that next day lockdown.
Relax.
Well, it's not my. I'm not saying it's because of me. I'm not saying it's because of me. But I'm saying, subhanAllah, bro. Like the first lockdown, I was like, there was so much time that I could have done things, and I wasted it. Eating noodles at 3 a.m. in the morning and watching
The
Office.
Another opportunity.
Yeah.
The Office went off, but that was a good takeaway.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that later. We'll segment into that later.
But then I realized, ever?
Nah.
I had gained weight.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had gained a lot of weight. And then I realized, hang on, the whole point of having that time to yourself would have been good to unpack a lot of things, a lot of aspects of your life.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I didn't do that. So I was like, man, I need to get another crack at it.
Yeah.
And then,
so what was the main reason? So you get like a second chance to,
yeah. It's kind of like
work on yourself.
Yeah, it's like you get a redo, and then alhamdulillah, it worked out better the second time than it did the first because I actually genuinely go to myself. Let me try and improve certain things, and let me go looking for answers for certain things. Like a lot of the times, bro, whenever we have like we get anxious about certain things, like for example, you're probably sitting there going, "Oh my God, what's going on with me? Why am I doing this?" It's always coming from a certain place, like within our lives. Like we're always anxious for a reason,
Like past experiences, that kind of thing.
Yeah. There's always something that's like kind of pulling your strings, and if you can kind of unpack your like the circumstances that have led you to do certain things. Like for me, he's probably social media. For me, I realized the office and food were kind of like my escape from
dealing with whatever my emotions were. But it's also like the thing that makes, like it's your comfort food or it's your comfort situation. Like when you are stressed, you have to, like a lot of people sometimes drive or go on walks or go on social media or eat. And that's what people,
I never thought I'd be the guy to go for walks, but I actually did that.
Yeah. You know what I find interesting about what you said there before? A lot of people during like the first lockdown, and then we had that little bit of a break off. Yeah, and then we entered the second lockdown. A lot of people were mad. Yeah, I don't know if you realize, but not many people were mad during the first lockdown. They're like, okay, it's COVID, something new. And then by the 6 week or whatever, they're like, okay, we have to deal with this. They still be angry. There's a bit of tension. But we went into the second lockdown. Everyone's like, Dan Andrews this, Dan Andrews that. Yeah, like they blame everything. No, angry in terms of, like, oh, now we have to go back into a lockdown. Yeah. No one wanted to go to a second lockdown. Yeah. I'll be honest, I didn't want to go to a second lockdown. And I didn't even enjoy lockdown until like the later parts of the second lockdown.
Okay.
But you know, I find your story interesting. Do you know what I mean? A lot of people blamed everything but themselves. But you looked at it and be like, you were like, yo, like.
It's an opportunity.
This
it's
is an opportunity for me type of thing. You know what I mean?
It's obstacles the way. It's like you can look at it as a problem or opportunity.
You have to accept things sometimes in life, bro. Especially when it comes to, like, we're Muslims, We know as Muslims, we know for sure. Whenever something occurs in our life, regardless of what you believe is fair and just and unjust and whatever, you have to accept it.
Yeah.
Mm. It's not going to change the circumstance.
Yeah.
So I think a lot of people had a lot of issues dealing with accepting the situation for what it was.
Exactly.
It's basically a virus that nobody had any control over, or we know of,
but also like no real knowledge on how contagious it is, what it can do long term, and vaccines. Like for Dan Andrews, he had zero idea.
No clue, bro.
You can't prepare yourself for that situation or a second wave, especially like Sydney had nothing at the time. Us 700 cases. What's he supposed to do?
Look at him now, bro. That's what I'm saying. Like if people had foresight for a bit, just for a little bit, they go, okay. Now we're buzzing because everyone was at the shopping centers, mask free, doing whatever they want.
Christmas was packed.
But you know what it is? Humans can't deal with uncertainty. Do you know what I mean? The least they wanted was for Dan Andrews to say, yo, guys, we're going to be out on Christmas. Yo, guys, we've got 6 weeks. Do you know what I mean? But every... Bro, I found myself at work on my lunch breaks, unofficial, I'd go in and watch his live streams. Do you know what I mean? Just to find out, hey, are we getting out of lockdown or not? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because it's that uncertainty, not being able to deal with it.
Also, you know what I mean? We have to
I want to add one last thing. And the quicker that you sort of accept that, the fact that like all of this is out of your hands, the easier that it is to deal with. You just go with it. Like you accept the lockdown. You start enjoying your walks. You start enjoying your coffees and the office and your binge eating at, what do you call it, at 3 a.m. at night time.
What's the hadith that you said, bro? The one the other day, remember?
Yeah.
Ajibun.
Yeah. How amazing is the fear of the believer?
Yeah. Say the hadith.
No, it's fine. Yeah. But we'll
leave it right there.
It's like that. Everything that happens to you, there's good in it.
No.
You know, if something bad happens, you can bear patience.
Yeah.
If something good happens, you're grateful. Yeah. It's like that's the affair of the believer. That you always either be grateful or just be patient. You know.
Mm.
But I wanted to go back. So what you made dua for the second lockdown? What was so good about it? Like why? What was the turnaround? Because, for example, me, I know I was kind of the same both lockdowns because I had Ramadan, the first one. So I kind of built habits from then because, you know. And then the second one was kind of like very similar. Yeah. How was it different?
Basically, like, because I think I focused more so on the spiritual aspect of life in the first lockdown than I neglected my psychological and my physical health. And then basically I realized that regardless of how much you try to increase yourself in a spiritual aspect of life, there's two other things that have responsibility over you as well. So like your body, your health, and then also your mental health. So if you're clogged up mentally, and you gotta go pray, prayer's not gonna be as good as if you were clear. Or if you can't walk up the stairs, and you're breathing heavy, and you gotta go pray in your prayer room, You got to go pray in your prayer room upstairs, but you're breathing heavy. You don't remember what surah you read in the second car.
So basically, you're not conscious. You're not aware of what you're doing. You're just heck doing it.
And think about it too, bro. Like part of us, part of our responsibility as a mu'min is the vessel that Allah has given us. We have to take care of it. And
the vessel being
their bodies.
The body. Yep.
Yeah. So basically, just I decided to pick up habits like like I said, walking.
Yeah, I remember you started running then too.
I started jogging.
At the end of it. Like you're running quite frequently.
Yeah, alhamdulillah. So, and you realize that no matter how much you want to believe that stuff doesn't have an impact on your life, just go to the gym or do some physical activity for 15 minutes. Just do it for 15 minutes and come back and tell me you remember what you were anxious about before that. It just disappears.
I know what you mean, yeah. I was reading about it and they said like, even when you talk about how exercise can benefit people, they talk about it like in the book Emotional Intelligence, Daniel Goleman. He goes like, for people that are new to exercising, it has the most biggest impact. Mm. But people that already exercise like consistently every single day, if you say go exercise, it doesn't really affect their like mental health as much. It still does.
Because it's like the second
nature. Also have to be conscious. Like you have to say, this is going to affect my mental, this is going to make me feel better. Yeah. You know, because endorphins, you take out stress, you sweat it out, that kind of thing. You go have a nice cold shower after. So you have to kind of like be conscious of it.
One thing I didn't realize was how effective coffee is in increasing your mood.
Oh.
Like,
no.
Highly disagree.
No, bro.
I know you guys are more coffee addict and stuff. If there's one thing that I found about this, that is one point that's 100% right. And obviously not from the...
So you said mood.
Oh, mood.
Energy levels or like how you feel?
No. Like actual mood.
You could have every problem in your life that you've ever had haunt you in the morning, and then you had a coffee and it kicked in 15 minutes later, you're on cloud 10. Not cloud 9, cloud 10.
You're the same?
His cousin.
Yeah.
Me, I just don't feel a thing.
Coffee?
I don't agree with that.
You drink milk.
Not just milk, diluted milk. It's a psychological thing. It's a psychological thing for me. It's not like the fact that I'm having coffee, I'm like, oh.
I think it's a placebo.
Yeah. I used to think it was psychological. No, I actually used to think it was psychological until like I started obviously increasing my doses of coffee, started drinking a bit more. Until like, bro,
five,
you know,
6 days.
No comment. Hey, but I'd say it to the point where, for example, I drink coffee for the love of it, all that kind of stuff. Yeah. But there were certain points like during this year which were a bit interesting. Do you know what I mean? So I used to drink coffee a bit more. For example, I was in my final and third year of my course. Do you know what I mean? So I was drinking coffee and I didn't know about it. Yeah. And then there was at certain times where I was dealing with difficult stuff. Mm. Yeah. So I used to actually drink coffee as a way of sort of like numbing it. You know why? You know what it does?
Well, it does.
It does. You know what it does? It increases your heart rate and you sort of like don't feel anything in the moment type of thing. And you know,
is that a good thing?
But I think
aren't you just like putting it in the bottle?
No.
But you know what it is? For me, it was a common feeling. So I used to drink coffee like regularly, for the love of coffee. But then that feeling it used to give me in terms of like the adrenaline type of feeling, because it does the same sort of, adrenaline being the hormone, it does the same thing as adrenaline, increases your heart rate and all that kind of stuff. Mm. So in certain situations when you're feeling a bit stressed, for example, let's just say I've got an exam in the morning and I'm feeling a bit stressed. That's just an example. That's not the example that I felt. I'd take it and it increased my heart rate. So I wouldn't sort of feel anything in the moment.
Maybe you two are different. Is that a stress reliever? Is that why you take it?
No.
Is one of the reasons to reduce stress?
You kind of just explained it was and then you said it
was.
Yeah,
that's right. Because then I'm looking at it, it's like,
for me, it's not stress.
I'd say anxiety, bro. It's when you feel anxious.
People drinking alcohol away your stress. So what's the difference?
Halal.
Is that any difference?
But the thing is, like, I'm there, though. With alcohol, you're sort of like not there. But then
people, like, doing whatever.
This is the reason why I think, like, for me, I didn't drink coffee every time I felt anxious. Mm. I realized that sometimes because of my lifestyle or because of the line of work that I'm in, I don't have the ability to have enough sleep for my body to go, hey, you know what, you're all right now.
So it's an energy booster.
It's an energy booster.
That's different, yeah. That's essentially
different.
Yeah. Because that's like just eating like you eat a carb dense meal, energy booster.
I disagree with that.
I don't know what chemicals.
Coffee never gave me extra energy. It just made me more like hyper and feel more in the moment type of thing.
That means energy.
Say again?
That means energy.
Not really. Like I wouldn't feel like.
Hyper.
Like hyper in the moment. Like I feel like I wouldn't.
It numbs his feeling. That's the word you're using for. So it numbs how, like your stress or whatever. It takes you out of it for a bit.
It's
but then, like, are you dependent on it?
No, I'm not dependent on it.
I am.
Because you're smiling. Like, are you
you're lying, to be honest.
He is. 100%.
No. Hey.
100% coffee is enormous.
He's like, nah, you know what?
I'm only going to have.
Yeah,
none.
2 days.
Yeah.
And then he's headache.
Not having coffee for 3 days. Stop every day you had one.
Yeah. I'm doing better now. Let's just say that.
No, but.
Hey, you know the 12 steps to addiction? You have to admit it, yeah? I actually admitted it to myself. Yeah, like,
step
this,
one.
Yeah, it was an addiction.
For me, it's just when I wake up, like I said last time, like me discussing it a while back, it was like, there's something you know that he can't, like, he doesn't feel like he's woken up.
Yeah.
And he's taking it. Me, it's not that serious, but it's something along those lines where I'm like, okay, all right, I've woken up now, I'm still in bed, okay, I want to eat breakfast, I need coffee with it.
But the thing is,
it just completes the morning, I'm like, I'm done.
Your brain does it for you, like it rewires it, it makes something normal to you and comfortable, and then you can't function without it. It's like, for example, people that go to the gym and take pre-workout. Mm. I go to the gym and take pre-workout, but eventually it's going to be like, your brain just expects the pre-workout, the caffeine, and it's going to be like, oh, I can't hit a good session. Why? Because pre-workout. I didn't have pre-workout today. Mm. Then 2, 3, 4 times. The fifth time, you're like, oh, I can't hit a good session without pre-workout.
Mm. Mm. That's where my addiction actually came from. It came from pre-workout because I was going to the gym like nearly every second.
This is the first time me taking caffeine, like properly.
Yeah. You got to be careful with it.
We're drugging now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
We'll have a chat after.
Yeah. Powder straight, yeah?
But yeah, 100%.
This guy's finished.
Yeah. I did it with Shifa the other day. I'm like, here, straight. Scoop.
Like, straight like that?
Yeah, straight like that.
Ah!
You have to. It's a better way. The thing is, it's also different because, like, me, I take it just for the gym. So it's not every day. And.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Why is that? Only when you go to the gym?
Yeah. But the thing is, I only do it now because I'm doing intermittent fasting.
So can you do it without going to the gym?
You can do it, but I don't.
Do you need it?
Who would do it without going to the gym? That'd be
I did that one day. Because I had to stay up. I had to pre workout. But it's like, you can only take it for the gym because intermittent fasting. And I feel like if I eat more meals, I might not need to. But then you guys might have a coffee thing. It's like you wake up in the morning. You don't seem like as much. Maybe like the other two. If you don't feel good, you need a coffee. Yeah? Like as soon as you wake up. Is it like that?
There's mornings where I'd have to come very early here. Or I'll be going somewhere else. On the way, let's go get a coffee now. Like, it's just like if I don't have it, or say there's times I forget I had it, like I didn't have it. Later on during the day, I'm like, wait a second, I have a headache now, I'm feeling a bit weird. What's missing?
Did dependency. Because of coffee. It's dependency.
That's dependency. So you can agree you're dependent on coffee.
Not anymore. I'm clean.
Don't lie to me right now. Bro, I didn't want to ask you because I knew the answer.
I have people that have been. Let's just say I'm clean.
Comparison. Okay.
If mentoring people, if being honest, he can't admit it right now. Yeah, he's clean, guys. He's clean. Don't worry,
right? If we're being honest, yeah, and this is not for the podcast, but at the start it was like 6. Yeah. Now I'm down to like 1 cup of coffee a day.
Wait, you said 6?
Yeah, 6 to 7.
So I thought it was 4. You lied to me.
So if you don't take
it was bad.
If you don't take it, are you not 100% legendary?
If at that time, if I did not
now,
take it.
Now
I'm good, but at that time, if I didn't take it, I'd actually be sick in bed for 2 days.
Hard to believe. I don't think you go from 6 to not being dependent.
Oh, no. 6? No.
Now
I'm on 1.
Yeah, you're dependent on that one. If you don't have that one, it's not a best, not a good day.
He's taking drugs.
You know, it's
nicotine patches.
Now it's more.
Peter Robinson's caffeine patches.
Yeah. I need that one. Let's just say that.
We'll get into the root cause of the issue.
But compare it to when I had 6, yeah? When I had 6, I was actually like physically dependent on it. Yeah. Like I'd go sick for 2 days. Like I'd have migraines and headaches and all that kind
you
of stuff.
You used to have bad headaches.
Yeah, yeah. Very, very bad.
So you had a different perspective.
I had moments in Ramadan. So for example, I knew I wasn't dependent on it after the... I think it's similar to smoking. Like you need at least a week to thaw off it, yeah. And then after a week of not having it, you realize, hang on, I did have a bit of a dependency.
Yeah.
And then when you realize that you don't really need it, you can kind of convince yourself mentally that you don't need it, and you can move from.
It's difficult the first couple of days, like anything,
and then you kind of push through.
And you also like 100%. Soft drinks or bad food. Yeah. You know, us when we try to
sugar.
Axe it,
yeah.
Sugar, like you. Sugar detox, you don't have any of these snacks, and then eventually it's like, kind of, you don't want to go back to it.
That's common with
things. Is that coffee though?
Yeah, it's because
you go back and have it for fun once.
There's nothing
wrong with coffee, mate. Like, sugar is bad for you.
It's the dependency though. Yeah. That's why. Yeah, that's all I'm conscious of. I don't care about the coffee. It's like being dependent on something.
But you know,
it's just nice. It tastes nice.
But your boy Matt DiVella talked about that. Remember, I tried to keep coffee for 30 days? Yeah. And he goes, listen, there's some things that work for people, something that don't.
And he enjoys it too.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so if he's enjoy worse, like he enjoys some tough ones, some rough ones.
Six. Also, cold coffee's brew. Expensive, but if you enjoy it,
not if you have a coffee machine.
Yeah, don't take it out of your life because it brings value to your life. Yeah, yeah. That kind of thing. So you should be.
But I get where you're coming from. Say the world we hit a zombie apocalypse, yeah, and then they go, there's no coffee. There's a coffee shortage. These guys are gonna start ripping guys.
Not me. Him.
This
guy's coffee. Yeah, he smells like coffee.
Yeah, there's things that you get like a physical dependence to, and there's things that are more like habitual, like based off habits and all that kind of stuff. Coffee is one of those things that are both. You get a physical dependence to it, and not only that, like I'm gonna say this right now, but I have a coffee machine on my desk at home, so it was
it was
habitual right in the sense that like
but it's also healthy for you. Isn't black? I don't know what type of coffee you have. Coffee is not bad for you.
But apparently the healthy amount is 4 to 6.
Yeah, say again.
The healthy amount per day is 4 to 6.
Damn.
No. But
like, I know it's very
article about it. Wallah.
The Guardian.
They also said that Spain. Sorry, they also said that Australia was chilly.
They
also said that Australia was chilly.
Caffeine stays in your system like up to 8 to 10 hours.
Yeah, yeah, 100%.
Yeah,
I saw a video about that.
What do you need 6 for?
If it stays in your system for 8 to 10 hours, and you have 4 to 6 a day, are you gonna have them what before 12?
You have to drink it before 3, but I want to change topic because we're doing a coffee discussion.
I want to go back. How did we get onto the coffee? You were saying something about you and lockdown and the coffee.
There's little things
that you notice that... Get here, man. There's little things that you notice in your life, that add value to it without you knowing. Like subconsciously, they've been adding value to your life.
Yep.
Like your family, for example, yeah? Your family being there and throughout lockdown, you realize that they're there. They're a laugh. They're actually all right. You know what I mean? They're not that bad. Those loud people that you work with.
Yeah.
Sorry, those loud people that you live with.
Live with.
You know what I mean? That loud lady that just makes you food. You know what I mean? Your mum, bro. she's mad, man. You know what I mean? She's actually all right lady, bro.
Yeah.
And then you realize, bro, like I've actually been missing out. The whole time I've been telling myself, nah, bro, I need to go out. I need to go see people. I need to go network. Otherwise, my life doesn't move, bro. I'm telling you, your life doesn't move regardless. Mm. It's not supposed to move if it's not supposed to move. Mm. Simple. Yeah. Mm. So whenever you start to appreciate the little things that are around you and stuff like that, like for example, the ability to eat, the ability to to see your mum, the ability to see your dad. Like, I got tight with my old man. Like, I never thought I'd get tight with him in my life. Opened up. We had, bro, I'd be awake until 3 o'clock in the morning with my dad talking about just life in general. And I never thought I'd have those conversations with him. But these things happened because of the situation.
Yeah. I was just going to say that.
It kind of made it possible.
Yeah.
And without COVID, a lot of the things wouldn't be possible.
Exactly. I was going to say, the year I divided into four. Pre-lockdown, yeah, which was just life. It's just it's a continuation of 2019.
No.
To me, it's just, I was working X amount of days a week. I was going out X amount of days a week, coming here. Just a repetitive thingy. And then lockdown hits you, like, whoa, what's going on? I'm here now. Mm. Wow. It's going to be a couple of weeks, don't worry. I just chill. You know, chuck in a couple of movies, play FIFA all night, do this, do that. You know, eat some terrible foods, da da da. Lockdown ends temporarily. Like, okay, this is not too bad, but it happens again. Like, wait a second.
And like, stricter. Yeah. Like, last time wasn't as bad. Kmart was open. There was a curfew, was like
this, that. And then, like I said before, it was like, wait a second, I didn't take advantage of the first one. Let me take advantage of the second one. And the second one happens. And then, after the extended period of the second lockdown, and we finally get free, have freedom, we're like, wait a second. Jan, February, March, and November, December, I'm two different human beings. I think every single person needed a sort of like a, like, I don't know about you guys, but to me, everything was just a blur. Whether tomorrow's New Year's Day, whether tomorrow's Friday or whatever, I'm just like, it's just a day. It's
you
day.
You weren't working too.
Huh?
You weren't working.
No, he was working. Bro, 6 days a week.
You remember summer?
6 days a week.
Remember summer we used to like do?
No, but we worked first lockdown?
Job keep.
So when did you stop?
No. I got injured literally 5 days before lockdown.
First one or second one?
First one.
So you weren't working during lockdown?
Yeah,
see, that was different because, like, for example, Legendary and I, you...
I was working too, but I wanted...
It was honestly a different world if you're working or not. Because lockdown every single day is different to, like, me, I was working 3-4 days and then the other days I'd have a couple of meetings or something. So it's different experiences.
To an extent, I wish... I can't say I wish, but if I would have changed one thing from lockdown, I would have wanted to experience it from the point of perspective of a person who didn't do uni, so it was occupied, or didn't go to work. Do you know what I mean? Like, you know those people that just literally... Like, Abshir type example.
Yeah, he would have crazy. I know this guy, he would have crazy.
Don't wish for that. Like,
I don't want to wish for it. I want to see that perspective because I'll be honest, I don't understand when people like say, or like, I went crazy or I went wild during lockdown and like, I was in my thoughts and all that kind of stuff.
Imagine being at home for day 22 and you're like, what day is it today? Like, what is going on?
See, that's what I don't understand. Pay rent, and some people were struggling because they lost their jobs.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, there's a lady that I delivered to who told me about her friend. Her friend committed suicide because of the difficulties that she experienced during lockdown. Like, so it's not going to be like...
When I say I wish, like, you mean I just wanted to understand from another point.
Even for a day or a couple of weeks.
Just see the other person's perspective. Because when everyone talks about lockdown, my lockdown and someone else's lockdown is two complete different things. Exactly, you know? Technically, my lockdown was just another world, except every time I finished work, I'd have to go straight home.
I didn't ask you, was it best or worst year of your life?
Best year.
Damn.
Best year. Best year for things being removed from my life.
Okay, interesting.
You know what I mean? You know, a lot of people like found things that like wasn't apparent before and it got brought back into life and whatever, all that kind of stuff. For me, like some things got removed from my life. But obviously I can't say that some things weren't like added to my life as well. Yeah. You know what I mean? But I'll say it's one of the best years of my life.
A lot of people like had tough years. You know, like mental health was on the rise and stuff like that. Like the challenges, we have to also like be wary. Like it's a very tough time. Like it was a couple of days where like even just a week, I didn't work. I didn't have work that week, and I actually lived like every day, like what people were doing for 6 months. And man, it was tough, even for a week. I don't know how people were doing for 6 months, because there was the biggest problem. It's easier to have a good habit when you know. In 2 months or in a month, gyms are going to open, or you're going to have a deadline, like you have to pay for something. You can build habits because you know there's an end date.
Yeah.
It's so hard when you don't know when the end date
Indefinite.
Is. And every single day, what's the difference if I read today or tomorrow, or read 20 pages or one, or read, like, go, there's no praying at the mosque, you know, sometimes you pray with your family, but it's the same every single day in your bedroom. Yeah. There's no change up, you know? There's no moving forward, so it was actually pretty tough.
Yeah, those situations where I was by myself, best situations ever. Yeah. I realized I was the most interesting human being on earth.
I don't know about most.
Not interesting. Not
most
interesting.
No, no, but yeah. It's not subjective.
I'd get bored of you after 20
Let
minutes.
Let me finish, bro. You all know I made the trip the other week. So.
Yeah, right, continue.
Anyways, nah, but dead set. Well, like being able to see those little things in your life, like for example, you have little mannerisms you didn't know you had.
You know even habits mean? And stuff, yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's like a big one.
There's certain things that you didn't, like I'm not even talking negative stuff. I'm talking positive stuff.
Yeah.
Like, you realize, oh, voila, I actually used to do this subconsciously, but it was actually a good thing.
Yeah.
Now I can see myself doing it. I don't know how to give you an example.
Give an example.
Like,
just say something you done that you realized or mannerism.
No, you realize that you get ideas. You get a lot of ideas quickly. Yeah.
What's one thing you realized though personally? If you don't mind saying it.
Okay, bro, what's wrong, man?
Mate.
All right, I have a lot of ideas. Like, when it comes to ideas, alhamdulillah, like,
yeah.
And creative stuff. Like,
he's a creative guy.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. But Allah hasn't given me, like, he's blessed me with that. You know what I mean? And I noticed that it will hit me.
You reckon?
Like yeah. Somebody will talk. Listen, everyone's opinion is their opinion. Yeah. But so I'd be sitting down and then something will just woof, it just hit me. And then I'll be like, okay, beautiful. How can I develop on that? Mm. You know what I mean? But I was doing that subconsciously in other things in my life. But you don't realize it because you're in such a rush to go do this thing and do that and do it. And then you sit with it for a bit and then you realize, okay, hang on. I actually have that capability.
Yeah,
that's a nice tick for me.
It's a perspective though. Because you have like a way of thinking that whatever happens, you automatically go to your way of thinking. Like, is this good for me? What is it bad? How can I improve on it? That's straight away coming to you. That's the first way you think, yeah?
No, but I'm thinking because I think the best thing for me was being able to get to know myself. Like, you know what I mean? Like, as a whole. Like, my downfalls and my good things. You know what I mean? So, the good... Yeah, you can't ignore the good stuff that you have.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, you have to be grateful for them, obviously, to Allah and, like, attribute that to God.
Do you remember Monique, when she was on the episode, you asked, how do we, like, increase our confidence and self-esteem and self-love? And she goes, know your strengths.
Exactly.
And, like, love your strengths, like, because that's who you are. That's your personality, it's your character.
And me saying that I'm creative doesn't mean that it's not my weakness as well. Because knowing creative people... Because creative people, as a whole, they struggle... with organization, with actually finishing whatever they started.
Yeah.
They have a lot of ideas, but they don't know how to just schedule it. So me, I struggled a lot. I noticed I struggled scheduling things. Like, this bloke tell me I got a calendar and I etched it in my calendar, my schedule. I'm like, bro, what the hell are you even talking about? What is the schedule? What's a calendar? Do you know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't even do that. But then you realize that you need that.
There's
no option because there's, like, for example, I had a graphic design job for a guy that I know. I carried it out for a year and it should have been done in like a month max.
Yeah.
Subhanallah.
Yeah, I carried it out for a year, bro.
That's what, like, I was talking to my friend about, like, goals. Because he was talking about, like, 2021 goals and he's like, should I write them down? But whatever's in your head, I told him, I just said, like, this thing. It's like, whatever's in your head is a dream. Whatever's on a piece of paper is a goal. And you have to write a plan to get that goal. Because it's like us with the podcast. We've said we want to do 500 episodes with this many guests. But if you don't plan for it, nothing's going to happen. Nothing's going to knock on your door and say, come, I want to record an episode with you.
You have to manifest your dreams, dude.
But you sort of got to know, like, what type of thinker you are. You know what I mean? Like, in the Principle book by Ray Dalio, he speaks about, like, He speaks about, like, you know, there's two different type of people in terms of the way that their brain thinks. There's, like, left-minded people and the right-minded people. Like, do you know what I mean?
Right brain, left brain.
They use their left hemisphere and the other people use their right hemisphere. I can see Seuss feeding onto one side. But when he speaks and he develops on that point, he goes, don't do things that a right person would do if you're left, like, if you think with your left hemisphere. Do you know what I mean? Work towards your strengths. Do you know what I mean? If you're not a scheduled person, don't force yourself to schedule. Do you know what I mean? Don't force yourself to plan and all that kind of stuff. Do it to an extent where, like, it's not...
So you're saying instead of, like, don't force yourself to become, like, someone you know, but do enough just to be successful.
Yeah, it's
you still have, I think, like, I wouldn't really agree with that. I think you still have to do, like, quite a bit. If it's something that's going to beneficial to you, doesn't matter if it's not your strengths, you have to do it. It's like health. Someone goes...
Work towards your strengths. Simply as that.
I bought a calendar.
Yeah, how'd that go?
First time. Sold. Did you use it?
No.
So I thought that was the doing.
It has crosses on it, but it has nothing else. So every day I passed, I crossed off.
Yeah.
But do you think that you should only focus on your strengths?
work on your weaknesses 100%. Do you know what I mean? But if you've got strengths, finding it out is a big thing.
So prioritize your strengths.
Prioritize your strength and then work on your weaknesses. Okay, do you know what I mean? Don't disregard your weaknesses.
Yeah. I think we were passengers this year. We're just passengers.
You reckon?
Yeah, we weren't driving nothing.
What happened to being the most interesting person in the world and you're a passenger?
No. You're a passenger in this thing we call life. You realize that you've got zero control and Allah is behind the wheel. Thank you very much for listening to the podcast.
Allah, my name is
Sahil Abdo. Yeah. That's legendary.
That's anonymous.
That's Abshara. That's that bloke. And we'll see you next time, inshallah. Take care.